Baby, bring it down for me. Or do I gotta control it from in here? Hey, what's up, y'all? What's up? God damn it, what's up? I forgot something. One moment. Stink today, baby. Not no stink today, Jack, baby. Look at all these pages. I got pages on pages on pages trying to talk. Listen. What's up, Doe? What's up, Carlton? I see my friends are checking in. What's up, Cynthia, baby? Pleasure seeing you. Hello, 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 hello. I see you guys are checking in from all over everywhere. I see some folks from LA on here. Of course, I see some Atlanta. I have not unpacked. Thank you very much. I see Florida in the building. Let me see where you're representing from because I need to know who I'm talking to. So can you please put real quick where you checking in from for your girl so I can know who I'm talking to. Yes, I'm tired as hell. That's what these bags is for. I am, baby, when I tell you I is tired, boss. I am tired, but that's all right. I'm here for this tea, though. You feel what I'm saying? Boston, what's up, Boston? You have to say Boston. You can't say Boston. You have to say Boston. What's up, VA? What's up, Texas? What's going on? Nicole is on the line. People tell Nicole hi. Nicole is on here to make sure that I keep myself focused. Ohio is in the building. Phoenix is in the building. Let's keep it going. Fade to Black is on the live. What's up, Fade to Black? It is going down here in the ATL, October 20th through 23rd. Thank you so much. Hello. New York is in the building. Come on, let me know where you're from. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Because I be wanting to know how far my reach go. I just need to know how far my reach go. Texas, what's up? What's up? What's up? Ain't nobody here from LA? Florida's in the building. What's up, Atlanta? ATL, hope. What's up, baby? What's going on? Miami is in the building. Listen, it is a pleasure to be, yeah, tell Nicole, hey, because this one right here. The After Party Society is in the building. What's up, Taps? What's going on, baby? Detroit is in the building. Please tell Nicole, hey. What's up, yo, 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 yo? What's up? Hey, I need to rap. Listen, Vegas. I'm always curious to know who watches me. You know what I mean? Cali is in the building with Carlton. Puckett is in the... Tampa is in here. Listen. Listen, y'all. You know we got to talk about it. Like, I got to talk about it. I got to talk about it. But let's get into it really, really quick. The recap. The collaboration. Did it work or no? That is the name. Children, when you're at church, they have to put a title. And then you say, Pastor, make it plain. And if you're taking notes, that's what I need you to write down. I need you to write the recap, the collaboration. Did it work or nah? Now, how many church folk I got in here? Let me see some hearts if you can even follow me when I tell you got to put the context at first. Then you preach it. That's what I'm about to do for the preach to what I just said. Let me see some hearts. Thank you very much. All right, saints, we're in the building. We're here. We're going to go ahead and get this thing started. Before I go anywhere, I have got to thank my show sponsors for this recap. First and foremost, WSI, World Steppers, Inc., October 20th through the 23rd. It is going down in Atlanta. I am super, uber, uber, uber. Is that an Uber? Super, uber? You know what I mean. Excited about that event. It is going down. Maurice promises to bring something different. So, let me put that right there. Let me put a little pin right there. Maurice promises to bring something different. I completely have faith in him on that. I cannot go anywhere. Like, every live that I do from now on, I'm talking about that Red, White, and Smoove. Y'all already know that. So, Red, White, and Smoove, the date has been set. It is set for June 23rd through July 2nd of 2023. Listen, the tickets are already available. You need to get them. There's going to be a limited amount of VIP tickets sold, so you need to go ahead and lock down your passes. For the Red, White, and Smoove, more information with Red, White, and Smoove, www.redwhiteandsmoove.com. WSI is also World Steppers, Inc. That's INC.com as well. We got Southern Charm always in the building. I got to represent for myself, you feel what I'm saying? So if you're ever in Atlanta and you need somewhere to stay, you don't want to stay in a hotel, you want to stay in a short-term vacation rental, stay with your girl. I got four that I manage, okay? So our website is www.southernstorm. I can't even say my own name. southerncharmstays.com, and also Steppin N2 Spring. That is going down in Little Rock, Arkansas. That's March 17th through the 19th. It is hosted by Pam Smith and Mr. Mark Cravens. And Alpha and Omega Travels. www.alphaandomegatravels.com. That is with Nicole. Again, Nicole is booked with her. If you're trying to go anywhere, call Nicole. Just call Nicole. Y'all gonna hear this the whole thing. Just call Nicole. She got it. All right. Now, I am going to first start my live off with a fan pop. Now, the reason why I need to start it off with a fan pop, because let me say my disclaimer. My disclaimer is such. My disclaimer is this. I am speaking from a consumer's point of view. I'm not speaking from me being on the bill. I was not on the bill this year. I'm speaking literally from the consumer's point of view, with loving both organizations. For me, this is not personal at all. And so I hope that any member of either organization doesn't take it as personal. It is literally from my perspective as a consumer and process improve. Right? So let's kind of start it there. Let's get into this tick. Okay. I feel so much better that I said that. Okay. All right. So we got in on Thursday. When we arrived to Miami on Thursday. Let me first give you this little bit of peace. I've never actually done Miami before. Yes, my throat is very parched. I think because God is like, girl, if you, let me tell you something. Okay, so I got there on Thursday. Now, when I got there on Thursday, from my understanding, there was a line dance thing going on with Maddie B. I did not get an opportunity to attend that. That is travel day. I heard it was good, so I can't really speak on that. I think that was the only thing that was going on when we got there. listen. Okay. So let's go right into the Miami, Welcome to Miami Touch of Purple event. That was there. There was the event. That was the event for Thursday night. Now, if you've been familiar with going to GDI's Heritage Ball, we normally always have the Thursday night set. Then we leave that set and we normally go over to Ellery. So if you've ever done that whole thing with GDI, you know that's how we get down on Thursday night. Thursday night was well attended in Miami. I was really surprised at the amount of people that were there on Thursday. Okay, so it was well attended on Thursday night. The sound, the energy was okay. I tried not to judge it too harshly because it is Thursday. So a lot of times that's travel day for a lot of us. So Thursday, the energy was okay. It was just okay. The sound system was great. Now, there's a reason why I'm bringing up sound system and energy. So just kind of keep that. Are y'all taking the church notes? Because I ain't going to repeat this. Now, touch your neighbor and ask them, do they got the notes? Did you write down the text? The text is the recap, the collaboration. Now, I need you to make this note. Put a little bullet point right there and you put the energy, put the energy, the energy, and then up out of that put sound system, right up out of that. Y'all don't go to church. Okay, the DJs for that night it was DJ Rodney Mack, Myron R, and Mello Chris. Now, by the time I got there on the tail end of Rodney Mack transitioning over to Myron R. Okay, Myron R always brings it. Enjoyed him. Now, don't really know. Now, this is not no shade. Now, put this over to the side. Put shade. Just put the word shade. Just put the word shade over this. So you guys should have the title, the energy, sound system, and shade over to the side. You can highlight it. I don't care. You can put an underline up under it. You got your highlight. You have to figure the vibe. Put shade over there. Okay. Now, this is not shade. I have no idea where Mello Chris was. I don't know. I don't even know if he was there, but he was supposed to play after Myron R. He didn't play. Now, I don't know why. Not her stuff, but I am not. What I refuse to do on this live is really talk about stuff I heard. I am going to talk about, that's a few things that I heard, but you know what I mean? It's just some things that I just don't really want to touch. I don't know why Mello Chris wasn't there. I don't even know if he was even in Florida by that time, but he was supposed to play the tail end of the Touch of Purple party, and he wasn't there. So I don't know where he was. And so I missed on Mello Chris on Thursday night. Now, because I give, let me preface this as well. Because I give events sips, I give 1 to 5 sips. Unfortunately, I had to introduce half a sips this time around. Now, what half a sips are, they are sippy cups. Now, if you have an Android or a iPhone, you should be able to go down to your memes and you'll be able to see the teacup that I normally use, and you will also be able to see the little juice box. That's what it's called. It's called a juice box. It's got a little straw hanging out of it. That means that it's a half a sip. I couldn't give you a whole cup. I had to give you a juice box. Now, if you guys grew up, you know, juice cups don't never be acting right. You pour the little straw off the back, you try to stick it in the top, and then it bend your whole goddamn straw up. It's a sippy cup or a juice box. Whatever y'all want to call it, that means half. So I am going to ask you guys as we go through this. Thank you, Ted. Ted has found the juice box. Now, it's going to be important that you guys make note. Thank you. On your little piece of paper there for your church, I need you to put juice box on the side, up on the shade. Shade, juice box. On this side, you got energy, sound system. Are we together? Can the church say amen? Let me get some amens because I need to make sure you're following me. I know I'm talking kind of fast, but I got a lot to cover. You got me? On Thursday night, I gave it 3.5. Now, could somebody please do me 3 cups with 1 juice box? That is 3.5 for on Thursday. I need y'all to really work with me. Thank you, Saints. I see the Saints on here touching and agreeing, touching their neighbors. I love all that. Please keep it coming. So I need 3 cups with a little juice box. That means 3.5. Do we follow each other? Cool. Okay. That was Thursday night. All right. Friday during the day, the vendor's row was apparently open. I didn't see the vendor's row until real late on Thursday night. Now, let's go back. The position of the vendor's row, I thought was completely off. I'm like, oh, yeah, I got vendors. Like, I get to that later. But on Friday, thank y'all for my cups, child. Let me relax, because first of all, I'm real tired. I just got back today. So I'm trying to. Okay. So on Friday, I had my yacht to come and pick us up. So we did a whole yacht trip on Friday, honey. So I don't know what was happening with these people. I don't know what party they had. I don't know. Not during the day. So I can't speak on it. I do know the vendor's row was open that morning. Outside of that, I have no idea what they did on Friday because I was not there during the early part. Hey, Casper, baby. I wasn't there at the early part. But let's go on to the dazzling day party. Now, again, I wasn't at this event. I was not at the Dazzling Day party. I was on my yacht. Now, the DJs were Trey Nicole, Samsonite, Vail, and Dan. I heard. Now, I gotta go. I gotta tell y'all what I heard. I mean, just like in the Bible, you got little stories. Let me give you this story. I heard that the day party fell short. Like, it was a handful of people in there. Handful of people. Now, you got beast of DJs on the box, and literally nobody was there. From what I understand, it was very low attended. Sound was horrible. That's what I heard. Now, if it ain't true, that ain't on me. I'm telling you what I... Allegedly, that's it. Allegedly, the party fell short. It was also $10 at the door. Now, let's talk about that quickly. I'm going to skip ahead a little bit, management. Just a little bit. Now, people were hemming me up going, you think my mama listening? Why in the hell do I feel nickeled and dimed? I'm like, what? Why you feel nickeled and dimed? Okay, so clearly people had a problem with paying for the regular pass and having to pay for day parties. Now, I don't know. I don't know, child. Don't be talking to me like I was not at this thing, honey. I didn't help plan this situation. I don't know. But what I do know is ballrooms cost money. Period. So sometimes you got to make a little extra money to kind of cover some of your expenses. That's the only thing I can think of. Now, I don't know. But the only thing I do know, it fell short. So I'm glad I didn't go, because I already know me. I would have been saying, where's my $10? Because it ain't what's happening up in here. Went down, don't know. Let's go on. All right, that was the Dazzling Day party. Rich African attire. Okay, so I'm going to coin this GDI's night, because GDI is known for, wait, y'all want to put some sips on that? I can't really sip. I can't really judge the Dazzling Day party because I wasn't there. So because I heard it fell short, can somebody put me one juice box? One juice box is like a 0.5. Give me one juice box for the Dazzling Day party. That's all I know to put. That's all I know. Y'all drinking? I told you I'd get some drink. Ooh, we just throw it. Okay. All right. So the rich African attire, I kind of coined that as GDI's night, because they're very known for throwing in the ethnic part of it, which I loved. The kings and queens that came into the building were beautiful. It's such a beautiful sight to see. I will tell you, though, that African clothing or ethnic clothing is very hot. Can you say hot? Hot. It's very hot. Okay? Now, that's what we had on. Now, child, we sachets over into this black, this rich African night. First of all, it's hot. Y'all know what I say. It's hot as fish ass in this building. Why am I already hot? This thing should be on Arctic cold. Arctic. I got on these hot clothes and it's hot. What is going on? I was so, that right there, child, I said, girl, and y'all know I got these Spanx on. I got this boob tape. I got all this stuff on and it's hot in this building. Where is the air? Y'all know that's one of my biggest pet peeves. Now, the way I normally judge it is when you first walk in, you're supposed to be able to feel that it's cold in there. Girl, bye. It was colder out there in the outside. It was so hot in there. I'm like, okay, I don't know what's happening. But, all right, so I'm hot. The energy was horrible. Now, I gotta be honest. The energy in the room was horrible. So somebody said it was nice and cold to them. Hey, more power to you, baby. Again, this is from my perspective as a consumer. I was hot time I walked in. Now, I didn't get there till 5. What time I got? About 10:30. Maybe y'all had done sucked up all the air by the time I got there at 10:30, because baby, at 10:30 was hot. Okay, Steven, I'm just saying that. You from Miami, you used to being hot. I'm from Atlanta, but we do air here. Period. Now, you're supposed to be hot, Stephen. You're used to it. I ain't. Okay, moving on. Energy, horrible. sound horrible. Let me tell you what the sound sounds like. The sound sounded as if we were in an arena. An arena going to go see somebody that's lame. Who? Okay, forget the part. The sound was horrible. Now, after me sitting there trying to figure out why the sound was so bad, as if I'm a sound tech, I'm far from it. I'm looking around and I'm thinking to myself, this is literally a warehouse. That is why it sounds like this. We were in a warehouse that was converted into a convention center. Because I saw the drop down door. You know the little door they roll up, put in the bag, the truck up here? I saw it. I saw a whole loading dock. That's why I am hot. And that is why the sound is not good. Okay. So I was on the side of the room that there was, you really couldn't really hear nothing much at all. It was vibrating off the walls so bad that you really couldn't even hear what was going on. This I can tell you why the sound was the way it was. I would love to know why the sound was the way it was, and I just got there on Friday. So this is setting me up for, like, usually when you go to a party like this, Thursday night is always nice. Friday night is usually always a lick. Saturday is kind of is what it is. You know, Saturday, everybody dressed up. You ain't really trying to get your dance on Saturday night. Y'all feel what I'm saying? But this is Friday. I'm already hot. I came here and I'm hot. Okay. One side of the room. Hey, Joy. One side of the room had lights. The other side of the room was dark. It was daylight and darkness at the same time. In my Smokey Robinson voice. How can you be daylight and darkness at the same time? Let me stop right there. Let me stop there for a second. I think for me, the expectations were so high that it was hard for them to hit. If you didn't hit the marks, I'm disappointed. I'm expecting these, let me tell you, I'm expecting so much. I did not get it so far. Now, this is on Friday. You are daylight and darkness at the same time. Okay? All right. Now, let me go to who the DJs were. And again, I'm not coming down on any DJs. Please don't get away. And let me tell you something. Before I started this, I'm coming from a consumer. Please do not take this personal. I'm coming from a consumer that spent a lot of money to come to this event in Miami. A lot of it. Okay? So if you see a little bit of a on my face, rightfully so. But let's keep it going. All right. The DJs for that night was K Boogie, Cross, and Kevin. Now, by the time I got there, K Boogie had already played, so I didn't hear him. And I want to say I was kind of middle to the end of Cross. Of Cross. Okay. Now, love Cross. Thank you. He's the sweetest person in the world. Love all the DJs. Love y'all. Love y'all. Love y'all. What in the world was happening? T-Lady, what do you mean? I'm gonna tell you what I mean. No flow. Like, what is y'all playing? Who's playing? You know it's bad when you're going like this. Who over there playing? Who playing right now? What? Is he playing? He playing it right now? You know it's bad when you start to ask. Cut that down a little bit, baby. You know it's bad when you start to ask people at your table, well, who playing now? Are you really trying to find the DJ booth to try to see who over there hitting buttons? Who's hitting the buttons right now? Now, the reason why I ask this is I don't know whether Cross was going out and Cabin was coming in. I don't know what was happening. But right in the middle of, like, people dancing, they played house music. It was like 12 o'clock. I'm like, ain't this party over at 3? Okay, because I know it's customary for Chicago to play house music at the closing. So people start getting their stuff, child. I guess everything, well, I guess the party over at 12 because they playing the house music. People start gathering their stuff. I'm going, it was a mass exit on one side of the room. I'm going, what is happening right now? I literally was confused. When I tell y'all, there was no flow to the music Friday night. It was absolutely no flow. I don't know if it was the matchup of the DJs. I don't know. But I got to tell the people, again, I came from my own perspective. I heard it from my T-Simples too. But I got to tell y'all the truth. Y'all would expect me to tell the truth. And that is what I am going to do. Friday night had no flow. Period. None. Period. Did I say no flow? No flow. If you're still taking notes, write up on the shade and write up on the happy juice box, put no flow. That's on this side. I give it 1.5 sips. Y'all remember how to do the legend on the 1.5? That will be 1 teacup and a juice box. That would be 1.5. That's what that is for Friday night. Period. Now, I hate to be this way, but I got to be honest. No flow. Now, I'm going to make this statement. Now, I'm sure there were people in there that thought the music was off the chain. I'm sure. There's probably 3 or 4 people in there that's like, girl, that music was slapping the night. I'm sure. Let me tell y'all something. And this is across the board for me. This party felt like, for me, musically. Okay. I said 1.5. I said a teacup and a juice box. But if y'all was there and y'all don't think it deserved that, put what y'all think it deserved. You feel what I'm saying? 3 or 4? Okay. But okay, that's fine. If you think it, that's where I'm at. I'm at a cup and a juice box. That's where I was for Friday night. Now, I was making a statement. Across the board, musically, there were some good DJs there. Don't get me wrong. What I personally feel, A, you catered to too many Chicago DJs. What? 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 Chicago wasn't all the people there? Everybody. There were 2 DJs, I think, that was outside of Chicago. Everybody else was from Chicago. Everybody. What about us? We don't want to hear the same song. I swear, for God. I literally heard the same soundtrack every night. Every night. What? What? Yeah. Listen, I know y'all got it, y'all faithful. I know y'all are loyal to people. I get it. I got loyalties too. Don't get me wrong. But baby, you got to know when your time is done. You gotta. You know, that was a movie. That was a movie, and I think it was a Tyler Perry movie. And Tyler Perry, it was the dark-skinned guy. Baby, what's the dark-skinned guy that was talking to her mama, and she was saying Lena Horne knew when they was in the boardroom. Y'all know what I'm talking about. And it was when he was beating the wife. That movie. Y'all know what I'm talking about. But anyway, he went over to her mama and said, Lena Horne was a classy lady. She knew when her time was over. She gracefully bowed out. Okay, let me compose myself. I'm going to need witness protection. Okay. Listen, let me tell you something. At the end of the day, I paid my money just like everybody else did. Okay? And this is not just me. I literally ask people, well, did you have a good time? Well, how do you think about? Everybody I stopped was like, what the hell? What's going on with the music? Literally, everybody. I did not find the 4 people that really enjoyed the music this weekend. I didn't find them. They didn't cross the tea lady's path. Everybody that crossed my path was like, what was going on with them? Listen, okay, I'm gonna go ahead. All right. Let me go to Saturday because I can kind of feel the heat. It's coming through. It's coming through the phone. All right. Saturday. Saturday, they had the walking history. I did not make that either. I don't know if anybody was able to get the footage on that. I did not. I don't know. Again, I wasn't hired this year, so a lot of things I did not get an opportunity to see, nor did anybody else get to see, because I don't think nobody really covered it. So whatever. So I don't know. I know it probably was good. I didn't even hear about it. That was the problem. Like, I'm like, I heard nobody talk about it. So that's always a concern. Thank you. The movie is Diary of Mad Black Woman. Thank you, girl. I didn't hear anybody even talk about it. So I'm sure it was good, though. Now, let's get into... No. Before I go there. There were three DJs. Oh, thank you. Thank you, Reese. He said the walking history was good. It was informational. Very good. Thank you. There were three hotels. And team, please help me. The first one was the DoubleTree, which was the host hotel. The second was in the Blue Lagoon area. It was the Hilton. And I want to say the third was the Marriott? Okay. I was in the DoubleTree, which was the host hotel. Now, why do I feel like I gotta bite my tongue? I don't know why. All right. The DoubleTree felt like Section 8 housing. I'm still looking for my food stamps to come in the mail, because clearly I'm on Section 8. I feel like I got a whole bunch of baby daddies, and this is the best I can do. I just knew if I moved one of them pictures, a whole bunch of roaches was going to come from behind it. That's how I felt. I'm not telling you that's what happened, but I'm telling you that's what it felt like. I felt like a whole bunch of roaches was going to come from behind the picture. Not that I know. I've never lived in such conditions, but I've heard. Child, I felt like I was in on Section 8 project housing. Now you say, Latika, why would you say such a thing? I'm glad you asked. Let me tell you why. First of all, I get to my room. I got half, not one hair, half. That means hairs, half, all in my tub and a ring around it. I had a ring around my tub. And my bathroom smelled like a little bit of a pee-pee problem. So I immediately had to go to the Walmart and get me some cleaning supplies, because when I went downstairs and saw the foolishness going on at that front counter, I said, honey, ain't no sense of you trying to get in our room, girl. Cause these folks is down here showing out with these management, with these rooms, child. Tea lady, go on and take your little happy butt on to the Walmart, girl, to clean your room up. Cause you ain't getting no better room. Girl, you probably got the best room. You can see the airport. You can see the plane taking off. So girl, go sit down. I don't be trying to cause no problem, child. I try to just be in my little lane, girl. I had my little hat on this weekend. Folks still notice who I was. I was still really trying to be incognito, child, because I ain't want no parts of what was going on. But baby, that DoubleTree was a hot ass mess. And let me tell you something. They had the audacity to tell you one cookie per person. Lady, I just found a whole wig in my tub, and you ain't gonna get me for one cookie? Lady, what?
So it was one cookie per person.
So they're saying, I was on the 7th floor. We had our ice machine worked. From my understanding, people had to come to the 7th floor to get our ice, because they didn't have no ice on day flow. Now, the word on the street was, the reason why they had them big old fans up and down the hallway is because the ice machines burst, not because they had cleaned the carpet. They ain't cleaned that carpet. They ain't cleaned that carpet since 2000, since the 99s and the 2000s, baby, when the last time they cleaned that carpet. That carpet wasn't clean before we got there. The child, who the folks say the 99 and the 2000s? That's when they cleaned that carpet. Period. It wasn't no clean carpet. What's a clean carpet was? Not at where I was. Not in the double tree. Because it smelled bad in there. It smelled bad. It smelled like mildew. So that lets me know that y'all have had a plumbing issue. It's probably with these ice machines. There's a reason why they're not, the reason why they don't have no ice in them. And it messed up these carpets. And y'all trying to dry these carpets out. But you trying to fool us and make us think you just cleaned them. Negative. That didn't happen. Now, before I go another further, I never received any towels. Like, I got my first two towels. We got two towels on check-in day on Thursday. I ain't seen a clean towel since. Matter of fact, baby, call downstairs, even though we at home. Call downstairs and ask the folk when they bringing our towels upstairs. We never got clean towels. So, my girl Crystal said, girl, I am finna go up here to this Walmart, child, and get some towels. You want some towels? I said, girl, bring me two and two. Bring me two and two. Bring me two towels, two fake cards, because I ain't got time. I ain't got time to wait on these towels. This woman, let me tell y'all something. This woman came and cleaned my room and still didn't leave no towels. She didn't leave nothing. We didn't have nothing to wash our butts with. Candyman get back and go, they came and made the bed up. I said, yeah. He said, they ain't leave me nothing to wash my ass with. I said, daily, you know. He said, if you ain't got no clean ones, leave my dirty one. So thankfully, Crystal brought us our own personal set of linens. All right, so pool parties. Let's get to it. Pool parties. All right, pool party one was at the Double Tree. Now, I didn't name it this. This is the ghetto hotel, which was the host hotel. I hate to say that, but that's what it was. I have to call a thing a thing. People say they didn't want to go to the bathtub party. I said, the bathtub party? What is a bathtub? Y'all get into some old freaking stuff. What is the bathtub party? They said, baby, that is the pool they got down here. The Double Tree, child, is a whole bathtub, child. People have a party in the bathtub? Oh, child, No. I did my yacht yesterday. I done got darker. I think my skin is beautiful. I am not gonna get in this bathtub. I already don't use those being no water like that because, you know, I had a little surgery, whatever. But I ain't gonna get in this bathtub party. I didn't go to the bathtub party. I did hear the music. Now, I give that thumbs down. But I didn't even stay. So I just went through it. But everybody was like, no. So somebody please put up a sippy cup for the pool party at the Double Tree. Okay. Now, we all went over to the Hilton at the Blue Lagoon over there in that area. Baby. The Blue Lagoon Hilton, baby. Had it going on. Oh, my God. The pool was beautiful. The pool was beautiful at the Blue Lagoon. So I'm going there. I'm going. Somebody said they didn't even see the pool. Girl, you would miss the pool. If you was at the Double Tree, you were going to miss that bathtub out there, girl. You were going to miss. But that pool party over at the Blue Lagoon was litty. It was litty. So everybody had apparently got the word on the street that the party to be at was over at the Blue Lagoon. So everybody went over to the Hilton and went over there. Now, I'm going to pause right there for a second. I'm going to pause there for a second because I got my pen. Do y'all still have y'all notes? I have to illustrate this to you at the pool party. So one moment. I'm not, you know, I can't really draw, but y'all gonna get what I'm saying. Okay, so we had that, and then you had this, and then you had that. Okay, and then this is like these. Okay, these are these. I can't draw, so don't y'all laugh at me. All right. Now, I'm gonna get to who the DJs were in just a minute. Now, at the pool party, there was a lot of people out there that really wanted to express themselves, and I'm with it. We are outside. So people were able to live their best lives, do whatever they wanted to do. I'm good with it. You feel what I'm saying? I'm really good with it. Hell, I even did a little something myself. I got a little nipple tuck. Is somebody recording? All right, so let's get into this. Now, again, I am all into being your best self and all of that. But I have to show y'all something. Now, let me label them. We're going to go to Exhibit A, Exhibit B. Y'all still there? Exhibit C. While I was at the, my throat got dry again, my moment. Now, the reason why I feel, no, wait a minute, Drew, you on my paper, I got you. Now, the reason why I feel that I can make a comment about this, there's a couple of different reasons. If you got it out, apparently you're wanting people to say something, whether it be good or bad or indifferent, you want them to look. Okay. I want to let the record show that I looked. Okay. These are the examples of the ass jobs that I saw. Now, let me explain to you. Exhibit A. This is the regular, normal sized ass job. You see how it's really doing well with the leg. You see right here, that's kind of where the, let me make sure y'all understand right there. This, it would kind of go something like that. Right, it would kind of, that's a good ass job. Baby, do you have gospel that you can play? Because I probably don't. I ain't even finished my illustration. And sis, this is a side view. So imagine if you're standing in the mirror. That's how much your ass sticks out from the leg. Same person, more work. Same leg. There ain't no different person, it's the same person. Or people, or whoever. The ass has literally dropped. Now, the only thing I can gather from the ass droppage is you sat on it too soon. Now, when you get these surgeries done, they tell you cannot sit on these asses too fast. You're going to flatten it out. You have to stand up a lot. Like, you can't sleep on it. You can't do none of that. And then you also have to wear your, I'm not answering my phone. People like, answer your phone. Dude, I'm not answering my phone, Pierre. I'm probably going to deactivate my Facebook page probably after this. But I got to be. Okay. Baby, I'm being judged. They're on here judging me. And I'm simply trying to understand what the hell I saw. This is the front view. These are the tits. This is the front. Sis, if you stand in the mirror and this side is smaller than that side, Are you a side sleeper? Now, you grown.
So, T Lady, why you worry about these people? They spend their money how they want to spend their money. I get it.
But if you come outside and I see this, I'm like, what in the hell is happening? Now, I'm all with a little nip and tuck, girl. I am with a nip and tuck, but Jesus take the wheel. If y'all ever see me out here in these streets and I look like one today, I could be like this. I got my known natural ass. But if I look like any one of these and I know y'all saw me and did not pull me to the side or tell Candyman, baby, T-Lady ass look a hot mess. If y'all do not stop, I'm going to personally hold you responsible. And then doubly, if you let me get all in a two-piece. This show is brought to you by World Steppers, Inc. It's going down October 20th through the 23rd, 2022 in Atlanta. They are sponsored. More information, go to www.worldsteppersinc.com. Saturday's workshop. I heard it was amazing, Drew. I heard that it was good. I heard it was well attended. So congratulations on that. That's all I can say because I wasn't there, so I didn't see it. So that's it, Drew. But I already know you delivered a good package. I know you guys. Well, apparently during this pool party, let me go back to the pool party. Somebody was on the live and said, they said a phrase that was actually pioneered back in 2020 by Little John and the East Side Boys. And it's actually something that we here in Atlanta say to each other when we want to recognize where we're from. So when we say we're from Atlanta, we'll say ATL Hope. Okay? ATL Hope. All right, now, apparently this person was live and actually said it on the live, and it kind of came across that this person was either calling people from Atlanta hoes or calling everybody else that was there with these bad shaped booties hoes. I have no idea. That came from a T-line. I didn't personally hear that. I don't know. But let me let you know that when you say ATL ho, that is not a bad thing. Now, it is a little bit hard when you're not from Atlanta to make that statement. You might want to be from Atlanta before you start saying ATL hope, because there's a way that you say it, there's a time that you say it, and apparently we say it at the wrong time because a lot of these people got offended. Okay? So stay where you're from, sis. Stay where you're from, because these fucking ain't going to have at you. What? What? So I give the pool party 5 sips. The DJs for the pool party was K Boogie, Carmella, and Samsonite. Loved it. Did not get an opportunity to see the top of it because I was doing Miami. I had to do other stuff because, you know, I had to do some other stuff. So, but I did hear that it was a good time. Yeah, so it was a good time. So 5 sips for the pool party. I hate to say it this way, but I gotta say it at this point. The pool party for me saved the event. Period. Up until that point, it was real low. Like if you put the average of Thursday and Friday together, what was that, like 3, 3.5, 1.5, you average that together, you might have got like a, I don't know, math with a 2. So for me, the pool party brought it up to at least a 3. So I'm at a 3. It was a 5, but you got to do averages. Come on, people. You got to do an average. So that definitely helped them come up. So it might have came up to maybe about a 3, 3.5. It really, really changed the whole vibe of the weekend. I see people agree. If you were there, please tell me that you agree. Because don't make it seem like I'm out here by myself. I asked y'all. Don't be acting like I didn't ask y'all. Period. I asked y'all. Everybody said they had a good time at the spool party. It's off the chain. Now, I don't know what they did over at the bathtub party. I don't know that about them. Now, at the same time, good job, Cincinnati. At the same time, there was a indoor pool. I guess you would be packing tonight. That location did save the event. Now, from my understanding, there was a party going on simultaneously as the two pool parties. Logistically, I didn't really understand why they would have that going on. I felt that was a little bit unfair. Let me tell you why I felt it was unfair to have that party going on at the same time. First of all, the pool parties were free, where this party that they had back at the hotel or at the convention center was $10 at the door. Didn't understand the logistics of that. The DJs for that party was Cross, Black Cool, and Rodney. Not sure why they had Black Cool there. That again, for me, the DJ lineup was just off. I don't know. Logistically it was weird. Like, what are we doing? So that was kind of a nightmare for me. Love Black Cool, love Crossover, all that, but I just felt that Black Cool should have been put in a different spot. So he didn't get a chance to really shine that day. I had dinner reservations on Saturday after the pool party. Went to a place called Island Gardens. It was on the deck. They call it Island Gardens, the deck. The reason why they call it the deck, because literally there are million-dollar yachts parked right there in front of where you eating it. Period. I was like, oh, this how they do it in Miami? And so then the guy came over there with the little board, the little meat board, and he said, the cuts of meat start at $275. And he kept talking, child. I think he went up to $500. Child, I would stop at $275. $275 for what? What you been doing? What have we been doing for $275? That is this a la carte? Child, it was a la carte. Don't give me no meat. How much the chicken? But it was nice. I enjoyed that. I enjoyed it. It was beautiful. So thank you, Joy. Joy picked that spot. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. All right. So let's get into the Saturday night Majestic Gents. I call it Majestic Gents. The only reason I'm giving it to them because it was all white this night. Did y'all think I was going to say something different? We was back at this convention center. Where the lights ain't right. Sound ain't right. Nothing is right. Now, I will say this. The only thing that they did change, which I thought was good, instead of them having us come in this way, they changed it where we had to come in on the side. And the side is where the vendors were. So it gave you the opportunity to literally go through where the vendors were. So I thought that was good. So I'm sure, I hope that helped the vendors get more traffic, because you literally did not know where the vendors were. Seriously, you didn't know. So I thought that was good logistically that they changed that around. Sound was still bad, still hot, still dark, daylight and darkness on at the same time. That still was going on. Nothing changed. Now for that night, again, for me, it felt like it literally catered to all Chicago. Like, it had that whole Chicago, I guess, feel. And I hate to say this because I've partied in Chicago, and Chicago don't even play the way they was playing this weekend. I'm going to be honest. I'm like, let me get that right there. Team, if you guys can put who the DJs were for Saturday night. I do not have that on my list. Who played Saturday night? Let's get into this intermission. Now, you know, it's customary that GDI does this whole middle thing. They call out everybody and say what they, you know, who their, you know, members are, what the members do. They did that. Do that times two. It was 73 people that they had to call out there. 73. 73. 73 compared to the Jets and GDI. 73 people. My God, can y'all call these people out together? Can y'all come out together like at a prom? Why is this taking so long? Huh? Okay. Now, just a little bit of shade. Just a little bit of shade.
Just a little bit. Just a little bit. Just a little bit.
Never mind. I'm not going to say that. That just don't sit right in my spirit. No, that don't sit right in my spirit. So I'm not going to say that. Only thing I will say is this. I swear, I was waiting on the Majestic Gents just honey, to break out in a quartet song, child. Oh, we at the barbershop. We at the barbershop. We at the barbershop. I swear, they look like a quartet group. I swear. They were cute, though. They were cute. But I swear, I thought people going to take the baritone. I thought people going to be baritone. They're like, Snoop and them were going to be like the alto. Okay, forget it. Whatever. Listen, this intermission was so long that, girl, I had to took my wig off, washed it, washed my hair, cornrowed my hair back in four braids, reapplied the glue, put my lace front back on, and they still were saying names. I'm going, God, what is happening? Oh, God, it was so long. Then when they finally got through the name, then they want to do the birthday dance. Are y'all ready to do the birthday dance right here? Is we ready for to do the birthday? It's me looking around again going, this is me all weekend. What's happening? Like, I literally felt like I was confused all weekend. I'm going, so I always go to my sugar babies because they're usually the ones that kind of keep me on track. Let me know what's going on. So I'm looking over to Joy like, Joy, what's going on? She said, girl, I don't know. Does anybody at this table know what's going on? Baby, y'all don't know how to do the birthday dance? It was so, I promise y'all, now this is, I'm not. I promise y'all it took about 15, 20 minutes to gather the people up there. Is it your birthday, girl? If it's your birthday, go up there. You go up there, then the man, if it's a girl's birthday, then the man standing in front of you and start it off. Why is we having to explain to do the birthday dance, and why is we doing it right now? Okay, so while they're trying to figure that out, I figure, well, let me go over here and get me some ice because I got my tea glass. So I go and sashay my little self over to the bar child. I say, yes, excuse me, can I please have a cup of ice? So I sit back and I wait. He said, that'll be $4. I'm sorry, sir. Oh, you said what? That'll be $4. $4 for what? I'm sorry. I couldn't really hear you. I'm getting my lace together. Yeah, it's a lace front. Y'all know I'm tired. It's what? $4? Sir, did you say $4 for some ice? Well, how much is it if you give it to me in my hand? Give it to him in my hand. How much is that? Oh, everything I love, sweet baby Jesus, and Mary had a little lamb. I will never pay $4 for no ice. For some frozen water? Frozen water. $4. What? Girl, bye. Girl, bye. Y'all should have seen how I look this man. I'm like, man, I know you're not talking to me. Your mama. If you think I'm going to pay $4 for some ice, your mother. So Candyman went back over to the hotel and snuck me some ice. I ain't finna pay no $4. I got it. I ain't finna give it to you for no $4 for no ice. Really? Now we at Saturday. Been through and y'all trying to tell me $4 was ice? That's the least you could do is give me some ice. Really? $4? Now, I will say this respectfully. Cheryl and Pete did try to, some would try to smooth it over by talking about the actual hotel, the host hotel, and saying, guys, listen, report it, call the 800 numbers, call and let these folks know that you're not happy with your accommodations. You know, he went into the whole thing, you know, they try to do us a certain kind of way, all that kind of stuff. I can respect that. I do appreciate Pete for acknowledging that. I thought that was a boss move. My only concern was this, and this didn't come from me. It was brought to my attention. As many times as Pete went live from Miami, did you ever check these rooms? That's a real question. Was these rooms ever checked? Because from my understanding, a lot of times hotels will show you the better rooms. Okay, I get that. They may show you the best rooms. But as many times as you guys went to Miami, there was no excuse for how we got treated at the DoubleTree. There's no excuse for it. None. I can respect that you guys did not purposely set this up for failure. I get that. I believe that from the bottom of my heart. But unfortunately, gotta kind of put this in your lap because you went there a lot. There was no excuse for us getting this. We're short staffed. I'm sorry, what? We're short staffed, and so that's the reason why you can't get any towels, because there are only two people cleaning. Somebody show me where I should give a damn. No, where I weigh. Show me where I should give a damn that you ain't got but two people working and y'all ain't got no towels. Did y'all cut my price down off this hotel room for not getting no towels and no ice and a nasty tub? I paid the regular price, whatever the block price was, that's what I paid. And there were some things I expected and I did not get them, period. So I can respect it. But y'all tried it on that. Now, okay. Where am I at? I just got thrown off by that. Okay. I did ask the question of this, though. Why was this the host? It's not the best one. Why is this one the host? You would think that the host is the better one. Not that you're going to put anybody anything shabby. I'm not saying that. But normally the host is like the better one. The better one appeared to have been the Hilton at the Blue Lagoon. My answer, my response was, we chose this one as the host because it's connected to the convention center. Okay? Now, are you talking about the convention center that we had to walk all the way over there to? I would have paid an extra $10, $20 to have my accommodations better than that. I'm just going to be honest. Now, I'm not calling it a dump. A lot of people came to me and said, this is a freaking dump. I'm not calling it a dump because I cleaned up my own room and we were okay. But some people felt it was a dump. Now, someone says the Hilton wasn't big enough. All right. So the reason why they chose that was because the convention center, I guess, the ballrooms at the Hilton maybe were not big enough. This is Miami. We can find nowhere else. I guess for me, again, the hype was there. The hype was there. The expectations were there. And by Saturday night, now I actually heard this myself, which I thought it was not cool to do. But I actually heard somebody yell out, give me my money back. Now, coming from, never mind. Okay. And the reason why my attitude is somewhat changed, because that was sad. That was bad. And that looked bad on the event. And although people are saying, well, you know, you can't really blame them, who else can we blame? Apparently the system had gone down in the DoubleTree. When the system went down, people couldn't check in. So I don't know if the management came with some creative idea to say, I tell you what, since we can't, you can check yourself in later, we're just gonna have a master key and we're gonna let you in. We're gonna take people to rooms that are empty and let you in with a master key. Get yourself settled. Maybe by the time you come back downstairs, the system can be up. Sounds like a fantastic idea. Only problem with that was it was already people in the rooms. I know 4 people that this happened to. When they got to the room with the master key, people were already there. This is my house, ma'am. Why are you in my house? Can anybody explain that part? They were already in the room. Ma'am, these are not vacant rooms. So now these people had to get their stuff and come back downstairs. What? One woman in her room. Man walked in on her with a fresh key. She in the room. And they had the audacity to give you one cookie. Okay. All right, so Sunday. Sunday. And you know what? Let me go back. I missed something. Apparently, well, we're on Sunday, so it kind of works. Apparently, there was supposed to have been some type of yoga class early Sunday. And a church service, actually, on Sunday. Both of those apparently fell through. I don't know why. Don't ask me. I don't know. But the person made sure, someone inboxed me, a tea sipper inboxed me, to tell me that while they were there to try to go to the yoga class, another young lady, what was her last name? Was Horton. I think her name was Lisa Horton. I think that's what her name was. Lisa Horton actually did an impromptu class, a yoga class with them, which I thought, so Lisa, thank you for jumping in to have that session with those ladies. Another thing that happened as well for the church service, Lady Love out of LA, the DJ, came over and just saw what was going on. She sprung right into action. And from my understanding, they had them with 2 or more gathered, baby. They had them a whole little church service. They prayed for each other. They had a nice discussion. That is what I'm talking about. You understand what I'm saying? So that right there along, ladies, thank you for jumping in to try to help save some of this stuff that was going on. And those ladies said they are forever grateful and thankful to you two ladies for coming in to do that. Now, I'm going to briefly kind of talk about, let me do the brunch first. The brunch, I thought the food at the brunch was actually pretty good. I mean, it's regular brunch food, but I thought, girl, I don't know, somebody mama was in there on them chicken breasts. Them chicken breasts was good. I'm like, why did chicken breast so good? Now, I could have just been hungry because y'all already know I had an edible. So, there's that. So, anyway, I could have just been hungry, but it was off the chain. I'm like, damn, this is the best. This must be a house-raised chicken because this chicken wasn't outside. This is a chicken that was raised in the house, because this chicken breast is off the chain. It's tender. It's moist. It's got good seasoning. So this chicken was raised as a pet. Okay, anyway. So anyway, the brunch food was good. The party. Anyway. Can somebody put me up two cups and a juice box? Two coffee cups and a juice box for the Sunday brunch overall. Now, y'all may say, T-Lady, it just seemed like everything was bad. No, everything wasn't bad. I'm going to give you some good in just a second. Now, for me, the good. Okay, take a drink. Okay. The good. The fact that two major organizations came together. There were no vegan options. I'm so sorry. Sorry. The two organizations came together to do something. I gotta give them kudos for that. That's not an easy thing to do. First of all, you got two organizations that have been doing events for many years, where one may have been doing kind of your one day events, and then you got another that you got another one that's just kind of did one days or whatever, and you got another one that's been doing 4 day events for a while. So I think the combination of them try to come together should definitely be commended. So let's give them claps. Let's give them claps for that. Let's give them hearts for that, because that is not easy. You have a lot of egos. You got a lot of different things going on. So when they say black folks can't work together, that is not true. We can. We just have to work through our obstacles. So I thought that was a good thing to try to do. I also thought that they had the guests actually at all three hotels were greeted by members of both organizations. I thought that was a nice touch. So you will have some people from GDI, you'll have some people from Majestic Gents there greeting you at each hotel. Thought that was good. The members all had on their t-shirts, honey. You know GDI gonna have a nice t-shirt, child. So that was good. So I thought that was good. The effort was there. The signs, they had beautiful signage. Did anybody else notice how these beautiful these signs were? The signs were beautiful, so I can give them that. The cookies, period, at Double Tree. If you actually got a cookie, and the reason I keep bringing cookies, this is the first time I've ever stayed at a Double Tree. I don't stay at a Double Tree, and it's the first time I got the cookies. The cookie was good. I'm like, this is a good cookie. So shout out, they made the good list. The free shuttle from the airport to the Double Tree, I thought that was good. I did later find out there was a whole bunch of issue with transportation and shuttles and all that. But baby, I was on the shuttle. I was good. Coming from the airport to the hotel. So I thought that was good. The convenience of the apparel mart. There was literally a whole like section over there where you could do some shopping. I did do a little shopping. Unfortunately, stuff wasn't really open like it needed to be open, but they missed a lot of opportunity. But I did do a little bit of shopping at the apparel mart. I thought the Miami Grill was pretty good. Now, I have to give a little bit of a side eye. It wasn't a lot of food options right there. And there were no vegan cookies. Oh, that damn WSI child. You know, they eat grass over there. So, anyway. But they didn't have a lot of food choices around there. So, you had to either catch an Uber or DoorDash to get to some food. So, that was kind of But we did check out the Miami Grill the last day. It was okay. The convention center. The convention center for me was a miss. I did not enjoy the convention center. I didn't like the setup and all of that. So that's a little bit of a kind of a miss. The Walmart was literally a 6-minute Uber. So that's always good, right? So that's a good thing. My room view was not bad. I could literally see the planes taking off. So I enjoyed that. All right. Now, as I said, the ugly, I'm doing my good, bad, and ugly. The ugly, of course, was the host hotel. I had to purchase my own towels. That was horrible. The additional charges that they were charging, if you've already purchased the ticket, that can be ugly, but I understand why they do it. You know what I mean? But yeah. And the mildew smell, the non-working ice machines. Those are all uglies. The bad for me, again, it the dance floors. There were three dance floors. The middle dance floor, from my understanding, was the one that was the lick. If you looked out and got the two on the end, you shit out of luck. You might fall, you might die. But if you get that middle one, you're going to get your dance on. That's what I heard. Now, I might have embellished. I probably did. But them two on the end, that wasn't the move. That middle one, they said it was slick. It had powder on it. It had everything it needed in that middle. Well, baby, them two on the sides. Okay, so that was bad. The sound. The hotel did not accommodate for early flights. That is true. Their shuttle did not start until 6. I had a 5:10 flight. I am still trying to figure out why in the hell did I choose a flight that early. I am still tired. You see me? I am still tired. Okay? But they did not accommodate for early. So thank you, Michelle, for that. The DJ placement. No. Just no. No. Rethink that whole thing. Rethink the whole DJ list. Rethink the whole placement of them. Rethink all that. All that's played out. All of it. All of it is played out. I'm sorry, but you say it. Y'all don't want to say it? I said it. Play it out. No. Just no. And it's not that. Let me go back a little bit. Because some people feel that. Some of us new school. Y'all just want to hear that new stuff. Y'all just want to be dancing fast. Y'all just, no. That ain't it. That ain't it. I'm 50. I ain't trying to dance fast. I ain't trying to dance no fast. I just would rather hear some music that was literally created when I was created. I mean, I was born in 72. No, I'm old as hell. I didn't realize I was that old. Let me go back. Let me hear some music that they created when I was in high school, at least. Give me like 80s, R&B. Give me some up in there. Everything ain't got to sound like it's analog. Everything ain't got to sound like it's got to put a little piece in the middle and it gonna crack again. Lick the bottom of the needle and like put it on. Everything got to sound like that. Everything, you ain't got to put a quarter on the little thing, honey, so it won't be skipping. Y'all think I don't know. Every song ain't got to sound like that for it to be the lick. Really? Really? Every party I went to, I promise you, I don't care what DJ it was. I'm gonna put it out there that I heard. I swear they all played. Now, this is no joke. One of the sugar babies said it. I'm not gonna say who it was. They should name it. They know they heard three songs back to back in the same order they had heard it the night before. Am I lying? They literally heard the same three songs in the same order as they had heard the night before. At least hit shuffle. At least hit shuffle on your Walkman. You got a Walkman because y'all definitely ain't playing no CD type music. You got a Walkman. So hit shuffle. Did they have shuffle on this Walkman? No, you had to take the tape out, and then the tape sometimes gets stuck. Then you had to take it out, and then you got to get a pen, and then you got to a pencil, because I used to use a pencil. And then you get the pencil, and give me something. You have to stick it in the little hole, and you got to do like that. DJ lineup needs some help. Period. Okay. Now, so let me do this. My overall, not at the pool party. Again, I said the pool party got a 5. I already said that, Samson. Samson, I like, first of all, do not put me down with everybody else. I'm not putting you down. I said the pool party got a 5. I'm just saying, the most of it was literally the same playlist. And again, I'm going to stop saying, what I want us to stop saying. This is what I want us to stop saying. And stop thinking. Oh, this is going to get me in trouble. Yeah, I'm probably already in trouble. Let me tell you something. Just because The DJ is from Chicago. Does not make them the shit. Period. Let that marinate in your spirit. Are we still taking notes for the Bible? Are we still at church? Somebody touch your neighbor. Wake your neighbor up. Nudge him. Nudge him. Nudge him. Nudge him. Major events, y'all need to start giving other people some opportunities. Period. You know, my mom used to say this all the time when we were at church. My mom was a I'm a PK kid. Sometimes I don't act like him, so whatever. But there would always be like somebody named Miss Jones. And Miss Jones always wanted to be in the choir. Right. Now Miss Jones used to have a voice back in the day. Miss Jones could lead some total praise, baby. Gay, put Miss Jones on the baby. She gonna put her own little lead on total praise. But Miss Johnson been singing for years. Her butt got shaken. She ain't got it like she used to have it. Now Miss Jones need to be keeping the kids. Now y'all can insert that anyway. You can put it. You can put it. I just gave you something. Catch it. Just catch it. Sometimes it's time for you to move on and do something else. Be a consultant. Hell, be a real estate consultant. Hell, sell Girl Scout cookies. Maybe the playing the DJ stuff ain't what you need to be doing no more. I know, William. I know. So overall for me, y'all, I am going to give the Miami collaboration of GDI and Majestic Gents. I'm going to have to give it a 2.5 out of 5 sips. Could somebody please put 2 cups in a sippy box, please? 2.5. That's all I got. So people that were there, please give me your scores. If you were there, let me know what your thoughts are. Out of 5 sips. If you join late, the juice box is 0.5. So you put 2 or 3 or 5 teacups in your juice box. That means a point. Are y'all still there? Let me have some thumbs up if you're still there. Oh, I think it locked me out, baby. I'm out of here. Love you. Bye.